Hey everyone, today's topic is potassium. And if I were to ask you what you know about potassium, what would you say? I can tell you what most people would say, bananas, right? But beyond that, many people don't know much about potassium. So let's dive into what it is, what it does for us, what are the signs and symptoms of low potassium, and how do we treat low potassium? So first, let's talk about what it is. Potassium is a mineral. It's a nutrient that helps keep our cells balanced. It actually controls how much fluid is inside the cell. Now, something important to know is that it has a counterpart, the other side of the balancing scale. And that counterpart is sodium. Sodium controls fluid levels outside the cells. So potassium is the fluid controller inside the cells. Sodium is the fluid controller outside the cells. And because these two nutrients, these two minerals, they're connected in this opposites kind of way, they're actually studied and talked about together most of the time. Many of you may already know that sodium levels affect our heart health, and high sodium intake is directly correlated to hypertension or high blood pressure. So now that you know that potassium is closely connected to sodium, you're also going to find that potassium affects our blood pressure. That means potassium levels should be considered when you're talking about lowering your blood pressure. So high sodium intake leads to higher blood pressure in general. It's the opposite for potassium. Higher potassium intake lowers your blood pressure. Researchers think that this could be because potassium actually relaxes blood vessels and causes them to get rid of excess sodium. And it makes sense. Getting rid of extra sodium will lower your blood pressure. This means that a high potassium diet can decrease your risk of heart attack and stroke. It has actually been proven that people with high potassium, low sodium diets are less than half as likely to die from a heart attack than people with high sodium and low potassium diets. So, where does potassium come from? Besides bananas? Well, a lot of fresh fruits and vegetables are high in potassium, so the more fresh produce you eat, the better. You'll also find that processed foods that are high in sodium are almost always low in potassium. This is especially true for processed meats, cheeses, and breads. If you're looking for foods that are high in potassium, you could eat fresh or dried fruits, beans and lentils, leafy greens, fish, nuts, vegetables. I sometimes feel like a broken record, but seriously, the more whole foods you can get in your diet, the better. I know it seems obvious that processed foods aren't that good for you, but when you're looking at increasing nutrients, whether it's potassium or vitamin C or vitamin A or even increasing your fiber, the answer is always whole foods. So start there. Commit to making more meals at home, packing your lunches instead of ordering takeout or getting delivery. Grab a banana instead of that highly processed snack bar. You'll find way more nutrients in fresh produce than in packaged foods with more than one ingredient. Whole foods are the perfect place to start when you're looking at increasing your potassium intake. Now, how do you know if you're low in potassium? The technical term for low potassium is hypokalemia. Some signs and symptoms of hypokalemia are fatigue, muscle cramps, constipation, and an irregular heart rhythm. And honestly, if you have just a mild deficiency in potassium, you may not notice signs and symptoms at all. The best way to find out really is to speak to your doctor, who can do blood work, and they'll find out your potassium levels. The treatment will then depend on how severe your deficiency is. It's also going to be really important to find out the cause of the hypokalemia, though, you know, you don't want to just start eating more bananas and hope that that fixes it. The most common cause is just not getting enough potassium in your diet. Someone who eats excessive amounts of processed foods, which are usually also high in sodium and are very low in potassium. So someone eating, you know, excessive processed foods, they can have hypokalemia, but that isn't the only cause. You might also experience hypokalemia if you drink a lot of alcohol. Also, if you take certain medications that make the body get rid of potassium, like diuretics. Hypokalemia is also common in people who abuse laxatives. Even if someone has experienced excessive sweating or vomiting from an illness like the flu or the stomach bug, It's common in people with inflammatory diseases as well, inflammatory bowel diseases like Crohn's disease or IBS. This is because the intestines don't absorb nutrients like they should, and so it can't absorb enough potassium, and unfortunately, hypokalemia is the result of that. So how much potassium is enough? Well, adult males should consume 3,400 milligrams per day, and adult females about 2,600 milligrams per day. And just to give you an idea of what that looks like, a banana has about 400 milligrams, a baked potato with the skin on, about 900 milligrams, and a quarter cup of raisins has about 300 milligrams of potassium. Now, as you can see, potatoes are a great source of potassium, but turn them into potato chips or french fries, add all that salt, and you're basically canceling out all of the positive effects of potassium. Because you're consuming so much sodium, your blood pressure rises, all that potassium is being used to balance out the fluid levels in your cells, so no, I'm not telling you to go and eat a whole bag of potato chips to get enough potassium in your diet. It's all relative. And my recommendation is always whole foods, minimally processed. Eat things as natural as you can, as close to how they came out of the ground as possible. I mean, think about it. We as humans evolved eating very natural whole foods. Our ancestors, they survived on fruits and vegetables and meats that are very naturally high in potassium and naturally low in sodium. Nowadays, we consume much more processed foods where salt is added for taste or preservatives, and our body is just not designed to process this much sodium. So this is why so many of us are low in potassium. This potassium-sodium balance is just out of balance because of how much processed foods we are consuming on a daily basis in comparison to those whole natural foods. So I hope this all helps in your understanding of what potassium is and how to increase potassium for better health. Let me know what you want to hear next in the comments below. Until next time, everyone, be well, and I will see you soon.